Methane here is a natural gas, and it's most of what comes out of your stove at home to cook with. It's a flammable gas, but it's not flammable on its own. It actually requires a certain amount of oxygen out of the air in order to burn. How much oxygen? Well, that actually turns out to be a very particular relationship. The relationship of oxygen to flammable gas is called stoichiometry.
To create fire, it takes heat, fuel, and oxygen. And when it comes to flammable gases, the amount of fuel to oxygen is a complex relationship called stoichiometry. Too much fuel or too little, and there'll be nothing close to a flame. But get the perfect mixture, and you get an explosion. Now, according to the movie, it took Bourne 20 seconds to get that explosive ratio of air to gas just right. So now the MythBusters are dialing in to find out exactly what it is.
We know that if we're going to get methane to burn, we need a ratio of between 6 and 17% fuel to air. The ideal range is about 9% methane and the rest air. What we don't know is what that actually means. Does that mean if we are a little off, we get sort of a woof, but if we get right at the 9%, we're getting a real strong bang? Before we go full scale, we want to really know what we're doing. So what we've done is make a 10-inch by 10-inch by 10-inch cubic box. And that'll allow us to really easily dial in on these ratios to see what it means.
And while Jamie is boxing, Adam has the ratios in the bag.
One of the ratios I want to play with is 9% flammable gas to air. This bag holds 9% of the volume of this chamber. I will fill it with gas. I will then hook it up to the chamber, open up both of the valves, press the gas into the chamber. I'll be displacing air that comes out of this little hole right here, seal it up, walk away, ignite it with a neon transformer, and see what happens.
Adam's bags will help the guy zone in on exactly what ratio of methane to air is explosive. And speaking of methane,
so that we can ignite this thing safely, we're going to remotely turn on this neon transformer that'll create a high voltage spark inside the methane chamber. And here we'll be able to vary the methane concentrations, ignite it, and see what we get.
First up, a test at the very bottom of the stoichiometric zone, 6%.
We're good.
Okay, 6%. In 3, 2, 1.
We expected something and something happened. Our frangible box separated just as we hoped it would, and it's actually kind of a little bit of a boom. I was expecting a little more from an explosion, and I'm interested to see if our optimal stoichiometric ratio gives us that.
Me too.
Well, let's set it up.
Okay.
6% is explosive, but what if Bourne achieved the optimal ratio of 9% methane to air?
9% in 3, 2, 1. Well, that was more energetic.
9% was definitely more energetic. But for Adam, the surprising thing is that at both ratios, they scored the mythical explosion they're looking for.